Now sit back, relax, and I hope you enjoy. Much love to all.
All the women who attended the crucifixion, according to the Christians, had gone after he had so-called given up the Holy Ghost, as stated in Luke chapter 23 verse 46, and I quote, "And when Jesus had cried with a loud voice, he said, Father, into thy hands I commend my spirit. And having said thus, he gave up the ghost. When the woman followers of Yahshua were standing at a far distance, among them whom was Mary Magdalene, and Mary the mother of James and Luzes, and the mother of Zebedee's children. So they didn't see everything that was taking place at the crucifixion site. Christians have painted this picture of Mary holding Jesus' dead body after being taken down from the cross. It is a well-known picture that is shown in all churches, at art galleries, and in various types of books. So they didn't see everything that was taking place at the crucifixion site. Mary Magdalene was truly looking for Yahshua, Jesus' body, to give him a proper burial. If she did know that Yahshua was well and alive, wouldn't she have come to the tomb with food instead of oils and spices? There are many instances where Yahshua is mentioned as being hungry, thirsty, or was just plainly eating. The word in Greek for spices is aroma. It is mentioned only 4 times in the New Testament and each time in reference as a burial preparation. Mary was the only person besides Joseph of Arimathea and Nicodemus who was expecting to give the final rites to the body of Yahshua, Jesus. As I said before, this is something that a woman does not do unless she is a mother or wife of the deceased. So as a wife would do, because his followers were not allowed to go near him during the incident, why it is recorded, and all his acquaintance and the woman that followed him from Galilee stood afar off beholding these things. Speaking of the crucifixion, they were not allowed to come close enough to see. And if they were, they would have saw the transfigured Judas that looked exactly like Yahshua, Jesus, on the cross. So they wished for those 10 were acquainted with him not to get close enough to speak with him. For his voice would have been the voice of Judas with the face of Yahshua, Jesus. Early on Sunday during the daylight hour, Mary went running to Simon, Peter and the other disciple, Barnabas, and told them they have taken the rabbi from the tomb. We don't know where they put him. Mary came prepared with spices for to wash the body of her husband, such was the custom of Judaism. If she was not his wife, no way would she have been allowed under the law of Moses, which they followed, to see or wash his nude dead body. However, Joseph of Arimathea and Nicodemus, the secret disciples of Yahshua, had requested the body of Judas, whom all thought was Jesus. After this, Joseph, who was from the town of Arimathea, asked Pilate if he could take Jesus's body. Pilate told him he could have the body, so Joseph and took it away. Nicodemus, who at first had gone to see Yahshua, Jesus, at shadow hour, went with Joseph, faking with him about 30 kilograms of spices, a mixture of myrrh and aloes. The two men took Judas's body, who they thought to be Jesus, and wrapped it in linen. With the spices, according to the Judaic custom of preparing body for burial. With a garden in the place where Judas he had been put to death, and in it there was a new tomb where no one had ever been buried, since it was the day before the Sabbath, and because the tomb was close by, they buried Judas' body there. So it was necessary for the body of Judas to be removed before those who did not know the full plot got there and found the transfigured body of Judas. For at death the spiritual transformation would have returned to its natural appearance. So they removed the body, took it to a tree and hung it for all to see. Thus, the story was made. an impossible story if it was supposedly Judas' own words, of how he went back to the priest in regret alone, and cast back the ransom money before them alone, then went and found a rope in a tree and hung himself alone and was dead. Then who recorded these step-by-step incidents conducted alone? This story was created by the secret disciples of Yahshua. It is recorded, when Mary of Magdala reached this tomb to anoint the body, she found that the stone had already been rolled away, and the winding sheets bundled on the ledge within the sepulchre.
Thank you for watching. I hope to see you again soon. Till the next time, much love.